An Iranian asylum seeker who took his fight against deportation all the way to the High Court has lost, despite claiming he fears for his life if deported back to Iran. The decision means the federal government won't be compelled to release another 170 detainees who are refusing to cooperate with deportation efforts. Political reporter Chloe Bouras joins me now. And Chloe, this has been considered a win for the government.
It has, because the federal government was so stressed about this case. It's still copping a lot of political backlash from last year's High Court ruling, which saw 153 detainees released. And essentially, this Iranian man was trying to piggyback off that ruling to try and get out of indefinite immigration detention. But the case was dismissed. The High Court didn't believe his fear of persecution if he were to go back to Iran was genuine, and essentially ruled that indefinite immigration detention is lawful if the non-citizen is refusing deportation. But if this ruling had gone the other way around, well, the federal government may have been forced to release another 170 detainees, which would have sparked an enormous political firestorm. So Labor is breathing a huge sigh of relief tonight.
And Chloe, it's the weekend before the budget, and the Treasurer has hinted at who's going to get cost of living help.
Yeah, so I don't know what these support measures will look like, but I know who it's for: pensioners and welfare recipients. So essentially the people who won't benefit from the stage three tax cuts that all workers are getting from July. There'll also be measures to support families, in particular making it easier and less expensive for Aussies to have bigger families, because the birth rate here is dwindling and Jim Chalmers wants us all to have more kids. We all remember the old have one for mum, one for dad, one for the country, but don't expect to see a Peter Costello style baby bonus in the budget books on Tuesday.
No baby bonus for all of us. Chloe Bouras, thank you very much.